Hello friends, I am Shailendra Singh and today I am going to tell you how to start up and shut down the Oracle database. The procedure to start up and shut down the Oracle database is same irrespective of what version you are using and whether it's container database or a non-container database. So let's go and see what are the different options to start up and shut down the Oracle database. There are 5 options to start up the Oracle database and 4 options to shut down the database. So let's cover first the startup, that Oracle database. First one is a startup, another one is a startup no mount, startup mount, startup restricted, and last one is startup force. Similarly, shutdown for this, shutdown normal, which is shutdown immediate, shutdown transactional, shutdown abort. So let's go and see what are the different startup options. This option is used to start database in read-write mode. When we give a command startup at the SQL plus prompt, it will mount the database first and then it will open the database in read-write mode. Next one is startup no mount. This option will start instance using pfile, spfile and allocate sga. This option may be used only during database creations or when we have to perform certain type of recoveries, then only these options are used. Startup mount, the next option. This option will start instance using pfile, spfile and allocate sga, and will mount the database by using control files and database will not be opened. This option is used to perform certain maintenance tasks like enabling, disabling, redo log archiving options and performing full database recovery by Harman, that is Oracle's recovery manager utility. Database can be opened in read-write or read-only mode at the mount-up stage. When database is at mount stage, database can be opened in read-write mode by giving command alter database open. It will open database in read-write mode, or we can give a command alter database open read-only and it will open in read-only mode. Startup restrict. You can start an instance by optionally mount and open a database in restricted mode so that the instance is available only to administrative personnel, not for the general database users. When we have to perform certain type of maintenance work, or we have to take a, for example, we have to take an export dump of the full database, then and we do not want any user to connect and perform any DML while taking backup, then only you can use startup restrict options. Another one is startup force. In unusual circumstances, you might experience problem when attempting to start a database instance. You should not force a database to start unless you experience problem while starting an instance. Normally, we do not use this type of options to start a force. If database is open, then force shut down the database and shut down abort statement before reopening it. And if database is closed, then force opens the database. No mount, mount options are used to start a force to perform recovery by Harman. That is by Oracle Recovery Manager. Hello friends, now I'm going to show you what are the different options to start up a Oracle database. And I have renamed here control file control01.ctl to control01.ct and sysauth01.db to sysauth01.db just to show you that at what level these files are required to start up your database. So let's go and see by connecting SQL plus SysDBA. Now I will start the database by no mount command. So it will read only the server parameter file from its default location and it will allocate the system global area. And it will not read the control file or any data file at this point. So you can see here SG has been started by allocating the various memory parameters from the SP file, and it has not read any control file or data file. So I will now try to mount the database and see. So here you can see it is giving error or 05 error in identifying control file. It is trying to read the control file by its default name, which is written in the server parameter file. It is not getting there, so it's giving error here. And I will rename back to the its original name control file and see what is going to happen. So you now you can see here that database has been mounted, and I will show you from its view, that is v$database. It is at mount level, has been opened at the mount level. Now I will try to open the database by giving command here alter database open. So now it's giving error again. Here it is saying that ORA 1110 data file number 3 sysaux.dbf is not getting. So as I have told you that it reads only control file at the mount level, and it will not read any data file or read log file or any file at the mount level. When we try to open, it will read data files at this point. So here I am going to rename it back to its original name. And now I will try to open. Yeah, here you can see that database has been altered, which is open now. I can show you here again from the database view. Here you can see it is in read-write mode. So these are the basic startup options which I have told you earlier in my presentation: alter no mount, alter mount, rather startup no mount, startup mount, startup open, which is normal startup, and at what level it reads the physical files of the database. And now let us see what are the different shutdown options to shut down the Oracle database. First one is shutdown normal. Normal database shutdown proceeds with the following conditions: no new connections are allowed after a statement is issued, before the database is shut down, the database waits for the currently connected users to disconnect from the database. And when we give a shutdown command, the next startup of database will not require any instance recovery procedures. Another one is shutdown immediate. No new connections are allowed nor new transactions allowed to be started after the statement is issued. Any uncompleted transactions are rollbacked. If long uncompleted transaction exists, this method of shutdown might not complete quickly despite its name, then it may use a shutdown about command. Oracle database does not wait for the current users which are connected to the Oracle database to be disconnected. Oracle database does not wait for users currently connected to the database will be disconnected, and database implicitly rolls back active transactions that disconnect all connected users, and the next startup of database will not require any instance recovery procedures. Next one is shutdown transactional. No new connections are allowed nor no new transactions allowed to be started after the statement is issued. After all transactions have completed, any client still connected to instance is disconnected. At this point, the instance shutdown just waits as it would when a shutdown immediate statement is submitted. And again, the next startup database will not require any instance recovery procedures. Shutdown abort. No new connections are allowed when shutdown abort command is issued. Nor no new transactions allowed to be started after the statement is issued. Current client SQL statement being processed by Oracle database are immediately terminated. Uncompleted transactions are not rolled back. And Oracle database does not wait for user currently connected to the database to disconnect. Database implicitly disconnect all connected users. And the next startup of database will require instance recovery procedures. And the instance recovery procedure will be automatically handled by Oracle when we start up a database. Now I'm going to shut down the Oracle database by command giving, command shutdown, which is shutdown normal. It will close the database, dismount the database, and shut down the instance. Here you can see database has been closed, database has been dismounted, Oracle instance shut down. So you can shut down by using command shutdown normal or shutdown immediate or shutdown transactional or shutdown abort depending upon your requirement. Thank you.